In the American church, most of us have not been shaped in the formation of lament. Yes. I mean, even think about like what it means to be American, the way that we do funerals. We don't have funerals where you mourn. We have celebrations of life. Right? Like, we don't want to, like, somebody like that you love died, and we don't have rituals of actually dealing with the pain of death. And so a lot of us don't have the emotional maturity to deal with centuries of injustice. And so then what happens is we got to find some way to try to repel this feeling, because we don't have this practice of lament on a regular basis, because a lot of our formation has been about Jesus Christ has died, rah, 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 let's celebrate. And that's what happens in our formation every week. And so when we deal with this issue of race, and you deal with this whole systemic injustice, we don't have categories, and these muscles are in atrophy. And this actually can be a significant gift, that when you understand lament, I mean, most of the laments in the Book of Psalms, the majority of the text is about how this is messed up. And eventually, like the last verse or two, is yes, but God, and there's hope. Mm-hmm. And so I think a gift that we can actually join people as we associate and gain with the lowly, we can just join people in a lament. And we can stay in lament for a really long time, because God is meeting us in the valley of that lament. And then we can say, yes, but God, is there's resurrection, there's hope on this other side. Like, God is going to intervene on this other half. It may be in our lifetime, it may not be in our lifetime, but this is something that is really key to add.